What is going on, Adventure Nation? We are leaving the Portland Fairview RV Park and heading back over to the Oregon coast. This is the Motorhome Experiment. I will say this is one of the nicest campgrounds we've stayed in a long time.
This was a very nice day, I have to say. It's a trails collection, and look at it. I mean, it's like paved spots, level, grassy area, picnic table, quiet campground. They had pool and hot tub, but it wasn't open yet.
Yeah, that was the only really disappointing thing.
Yeah, but I know.
Let's jump in the RV, and then we'll talk about it on the way out. I shot a little, I shot some stuff at the campground so we can talk about it while we're rolling.
Absolutely.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Ozzy, come on, buddy. Back in, dude.
Come on,
man. Back in, time to go. He hates road days. As we leave the Portland Fairview RV Park, we can talk to you a little bit about it. In the Thousand Trails membership, there is a separate park called the Trails Collection. This is part of the Trails Collection, and it's their Encore properties. And their Encore properties are supposed to be their nicer, higher-end properties. Not always the case, as we found out with the San Francisco RV resort, but this particular one, I guess they just acquired it a few years ago, which is kind of like makes sense now. It's so well maintained, like from the clubhouse to the restrooms to the back of the campground. Even the annual sites are just
spotless.
Like they're, you can see that their expectations are super high, and you either meet them or you probably get out. So that's really, really cool.
And they had a lot of flowers, and it's that time of the year that everything is blooming. So they have a working room. I have not seen that in a campground. Very rarely, in a campground, a workout room.
Yeah, the workout was like a little building, like a little cabin in it, you know, like a yoga studio almost. And then it had the little duck pond behind it. Kevin and Laura said they saw little baby ducks and stuff in there.
We didn't see any,
but we did see ducks. And then the back of the park was just beautiful. It really was. Now, if you do stay down in the back of the park, there is going to be some train noise. We could hear it up front, but it wasn't too bad. We were right along the road, so there was some road noise. But it's like anything else. You kind of like turns into white noise, and yeah, you.
And it's this campground has for the most part pull throughs, like very, very few back ends. We happen to be in a back end, but very few of them.
But just a beautiful campground, nice stay. The people were nice. We didn't interact with staff too much, but check-in process was nice. The ladies were nice this morning when I picked up packages and things. So, just a great stay here in Portland, and we're about what, 15 to 20 minutes from downtown Portland with moderate traffic.
Handy.
It was pretty handy. And handy to the gorge as well to get out and do some hiking and stuff. But now we're gonna go get the coach washed, and then we're gonna head back over to the coast and get the coach dirty again. So I don't know really about getting the coach washed, but it really needs it. We rolled in here to the Blue Beacon truck wash at the Jubitz Travel Center, hoping to get the coach washed, but we're about 6th or 8th in line. That's not gonna happen. So
I think more than that.
Maybe even more than that. It'll take 2 hours to get us washed, so we are not gonna do that. We are gonna roll out, so we will either wash it ourselves down the road or go somewhere else, but this is crazy.
Yeah, all the trucks on the right are the ones waiting for the wash. And an RV, the one you saw passing. Good news!
We've saved 15% by switching. No, we didn't. Yeah. We were leaving the truck washer and we saw a little sign that said truck wash. So we turned in and we're like 2nd or 3rd in line. So
I guess nobody knows about this one.
Yeah. And we can see the other truck wash from where we are.
Can I see that?
So yeah, literally, you can see in the camera, the blue building over there on the left, the turquoise blue, that's Blue Beacon Wash. And so it's literally on the other side of the fence. So kind of good for us. Worked out great. Of course, this could be $400. We didn't really ask because there's less of a wait. We don't know. We met with some viewers last night, and they were asking one of the things that we loved about our Class A. This is it. We're grabbing some burritos while we're in line. And Lori just ran the microwave. Now we can kick back and have something to eat while we're waiting.
That was a lot of cooking.
Come on, no!
So this place here in Portland was called JLE Truck Wash. It was right behind the Jubitz Travel Center and the Blue Beacon. Our coach was $42 to wash it. And I tried to give them a tip. They're not allowed to take tips. I tried to throw the guys $20 and they said the big boss doesn't allow us to take tips. So I'm going to have to write JLE and tell the big boss that that's not cool. Like,
they did a lot of work for us.
They do a lot of work, so... Anyways, they did a good job from what I can see so far, and the main purpose was to get all the salt and stuff off from the last couple of months. So, yeah, now we're on the road again.
Clean windshield.
And yeah, you guys will be happy to see the windshield's clean. That's crazy. Come on, man. Allow your guys to make a couple of bucks. I mean, again, you have to watch that stuff because you don't want them doing stupid stuff because they took a tip, but at the same time, if the job's well done, come on. To the opposite side of the Columbia River, we will wish everyone a warm welcome
to Washington State. Woo-hoo. My first time in Washington, Paul has been here before, but my first time.
I've only been to Seattle. Like, I flew in and flew out of Seattle. Like, I've never crossed the Columbia River. Well, holy smokes, this is a big river.
But you have been in Washington, though.
Right. I have been in Washington.
Yeah.
But, man, what an amazing river crossing that is. Holy smokes, that bridge is crazy.
It's a huge river.
Huge river, huge bridge. And we will be back tomorrow because we're going to check out Astoria and stuff.
Now you can start seeing the swells coming from the ocean.
Yeah. We are all checked in. We are at the Long Beach Thousand Trails in Seaview, Washington. And we're just gonna go out, pick a site, and then we'll get set up for the night, get some work done, and I think we're gonna have to do a little hot tub action. Cause yes, the hot tub is open.
Yeah! I'm excited.
Good morning, everybody. We are in Seaview, Oregon, I believe, just outside of Astoria. And today we're gonna go get our Goonie on. So, are you ready for that?
We even watched a movie last night so we could recognize the places.
We did re-watch it. And just so you guys know, the wash that we did on the RV yesterday was complete wipeout because it rained last night. So, that's always awesome. Ready to go?
Yes.
Let's do this. For those of you who don't know what Goonies is, one, what planet have you been living on? And two,
be somebody from a different country.
What is wrong with you? You're obviously very miserable and don't like having any fun.
Or you're from a different country.
Or you might be from a different country. Jeez. And just may have never seen it. But Goonies is a movie from 1985. I would describe it as like a kid's... right in the middle of our video, she interrupts with doing the windshield.
It was just without noise.
We're trying to film here.
I'm sorry. Just stay quiet, like always.
Oh, okay,
wow. That's why I don't talk.
Oh, please.
I think you can go left if you want to.
So, Goonies was from 1985. It was a kid's movie, very similar to like a kid's Indiana Jones kind of movie, but super fun, kind of funny. And a lot of like great actors who at the time were child actors. Josh Brolin, who it's quite a stretch from going to Goonies to what, last movie, like Sicario, and now he's like in Captain America and stuff. But great, great actors in that. And so we're gonna go play around in Astoria and Cannon Beach and some of those areas where it was filmed.
And for me, I never known about these actors until I got to this country.
Yep.
So.
And now you do.
Don't feel bad if you don't know them.
Okay, and now we're in Cannon Beach, and we're here in Cannon Beach for a couple of things. One, to continue our Goonies adventure, because this here, this is where the Fratellis came, and they came with their little SUV, and they come blasting down here and out onto the beach where they had their race. And that's
literally the start of the movie.
That's the start of the movie, but we're gonna go and check out Haystack Rock as well. And I don't think they do any more racing on the beach here, I'm not sure.
But guess what? It's supposed to be puffin season.
Oh yes.
So we're hoping to see puffins taking off the shoes.
So I should probably take off my shoes as well.
Or they're gonna get full of sand.
Is that a jellyfish? It is a jellyfish. I don't know if you guys will hear me or not, but windy as heck. This is Haystack Rock, and right now there's supposed to be puffin season that starts in April. They lay eggs, and then they protect the nests from the other birds, but we don't see any puffins, really.
Not one.
But it is a pretty cool rock, as rocks go.
Yes.
If you guys didn't know, this is what a puffin looks like, and we didn't see any of those out there. Lots of the mirrors, or murres. And that, but none of those guys. All right, before we leave Cannon Beach, we decided to stop at the Pelican Brewing Company for a little lunch, but check out this clock. Look at that. It is a tide clock, so you can tell when high tide, low tide, and things are gonna happen. So 3 hours to low tide, that's kind of cool. I have never seen one of those before. I don't know if it works, but I haven't seen one of those before. All right, we were walking by to go to the car, and we thought, we gotta come in here. Check that out. The Cannon Beach Hardware and Public House.
So it's a brewery and a hardware store.
In one. So.
So it makes both of us happy.
Yeah, we go. Go in here. Oh, that's hilarious. Hey, how's it going? That is hilarious. Okay, so the hardware and public ale house, like just craziness. Full hardware store, full bar. So I've been wanting to get a better axe for a long time now, so.
We got a souvenir.
So I got my souvenir, and the guy also told me that, I said, I'm gonna feel weird walking down the street with an axe, and he goes, oh yeah, well there's no open container law either. So you can buy a bottle of alcohol and walk down the street while drinking it and wielding an axe. That's awesome. I'm liking Oregon more and more.
There's something wrong with that. Like, you should be with the come with the first aid kit.
Yes.
And I know that's my woozy inside talking, my city girl inside talking.
So if you're in the Cannon Beach area and you do want to come in your RV, there is RV spots and there are signs everywhere that tells you how to do how to get to the RV parking. The problem again is, like, we couldn't fit our RV here with our tow. We would have to unhook and then park the car in a separate spot. But that is an option if you want to come here. And it's a really cute town.
What, a 38 foot will fit here without a tow?
Without a tow.
And it's not the only parking lot in town that fits RV. So there is like two sections of the tourist area here. This is one section on the, what is it, the south side?
Yes.
And there is one other section with the RV parking
on the north side. No, we don't know if that'll fit or not, but cool. Let's head on up the road. Get back to Astoria. One of the most disturbing things we read is right along this stretch of highway here, if you're coming through here at night, that there's a ghost called the Bandage Man that kind of sometimes jumps into passenger vehicles. Luckily, we're driving through here in the daytime because we just bought an axe and we would have supplied him with an axe in our back seat. That wouldn't be a good thing to supply a guy.
I guess there's like some reports of people saying a hitchhiker jumped into my car. So it's not one crazy person, I guess there's reports about it.
No, there's many crazy people that said there was a report of it.
But it's not one, it's mainly coincidental crazy people.
Yeah, I don't
just
know,
saying,
but
just putting it out there.
Yeah. This really cool Victorian behind us is the Flavel House Museum, and I believe it's the actual museum that Mikey's dad worked at in the movie. So, pretty cool. It's a beautiful building.
And we're gonna see what's across the street.
The opening sequence of the movie, the Goonies, the Fratellis are busting out their brother and or son, and this is the building here, the jail, where they shot that opening sequence. So that's pretty cool.
And look what they have here too.
Yeah, and they've got the Jeep from the movie here as well. Even up to the bullet holes in the back. There's a scene in the movie where Chunk's pointing out the bullet holes, where he finds it in the garage. Even the bullet holes are there. How cool is that? So obviously a lot of this stuff has changed since then. I'm gonna have to watch again and see if this building here shows up in the movie or not. But I know this looked like a little street out front at one point. But, yep, that's the county jail, and it's now also home to the Oregon Film Festival, or Film Museum, that is. So, obviously closed at this time of day, but.
But it's kind of cool to see it, though.
Very cool, yes.
This is the driveway.
So, as you can see, they don't want anybody going up there and taking pictures and stuff. I think they're missing a huge opportunity by charging $5 or something like that to get up there. So, but there is something else we're gonna try because they didn't say that we couldn't do this. The Colombian theater here in Astoria. It was really cool, and the Isle of Dogs movie was pretty good.
Unexpectedly good. If you're a dog person, actually, you will love that movie.
Oh, if you're a dog person, absolutely. But a cute little stop motion animation, like Japanese thing, so it's very, very cool. Now we're just gonna walk around Astoria. Check this out, look at that. I don't know if you'll be able to see that or not. The giant ships just waiting out there to get loaded up. Unfortunately, probably loaded with trees to take over to overseas, but that's crazy. We're just gonna finish up with a little walk around Astoria and then we're gonna head back to the RV. It's weird, it's like 8:30 at night, I think almost 9 o'clock at night, and it's still light out. So crazy. Again, cute little town, and probably a place that we'll come back to at some point.
Yes, I mean, I could spend a few days here. It's just like a charming town, and mostly in downtown, I think it's pretty cool.
Oh, one more thing that we gotta do.
What?
We'll go this way in just a minute. Okay, I promise, the last Goonies thing, but I'm pretty sure this is where Chunk was looking out the windows, where he smashes the pizza and the shake against the glass, and it splashes all over him, so they're coming from down this way. And he sees him coming this way, and he's at one of these windows here. I think, I don't know. They said the bowling alley was in downtown, and we're in downtown, so. All right, guys, go to sleep, good night, and we'll see you guys in the morning. Good night. Don't go to sleep, you gotta watch the rest of this video. We're gonna go to sleep and catch up with you. You know what we're talking about. Good morning, everybody. Rolling out of the campground here a little bit after checkout, because of all places, Astoria wound up being a fun nighttime scene.
Yes.
We went and saw a pretty neat movie at the Columbian Theater, and then right next to the Columbian Theater, the guy that was selling tickets at the Columbian Theater was the bass player for the jazz band at the Voodoo Lounge next door, so we went there, and it was fun. It was really cool. So we wound up hanging out there watching his band. I'm assuming the guy's probably the owner of the whole thing, but I don't know that for sure, but it was fun. So Astoria turned out to be a pretty cool little stop. This campground, again, was one of those quick means to an end. Two nights here and we're out.
It's not too bad of a campground. It's actually, the surrounding areas are very well maintained. The sites is just one after another. It's just no privacy per se.
The hookups are really, really weird. Literally every other site is not really that usable because you're hookups are on the complete opposite side, so you'd have to have a 50-foot sewer hose, which some people did, some of the full-time people did, but the odd-numbered sites were just not usable for us, so we stayed in even-numbered sites, which they warned us about, but that was kind of weird. So there's basically four sites on one hookup set, so that's a little bit crazy. But it's pretty. We never got a chance to see the beach. It's literally right on the beach as well. But we did get to see a lot of stuff yesterday that was really, really cool.
And they have some amenities in this campground. They have a nice laundry area. They have pool and a hot tub. But the hot tub is just like literally fits four people and it's tight.
Yes.
But I mean, it looked very nice. Never went to the bathroom, so I couldn't tell you there.
But off and running up the coast, it's going to continue up 101. Today's just a 120-mile drive, so we don't have that far to go. We have arrived at Oceana, the Thousand Trails up here in Ocean City, Washington. It's taken me a while to realize that we're in Washington. I've been calling it Oregon all day and driving Lori crazy, but we are in Washington. They have a few full hookup sites up front, but he said the better sites are water electric only in the back. So out to the back we go. Wow, the laundry room is a trailer. That's interesting. But it looks really nice. That's really okay. Cool. That's a first. And they are right on the ocean. He said we will hear the waves, but we can't see the ocean because of a nature preserve, but we are able to drive out to the nature preserve. So this will be cool. We are gonna drive across the wooden bridge on the way out here. These next few days, we are gonna do nothing but get work done, so.
Yay.
we've got to get some stuff done before we head into Seattle and before we get north heading up into Alaska. So that's what these few days out in the middle of nowhere are going to do.
There's no temptation to go.
No temptation.
Because there's nothing around here.
So let's see what we got. He said there's a dozen rigs or so back here, and that looks to be about it. So I think we'll just find one of these spots over here on the left and be done with her. Well, Miss Lorena, the drive from Portland over to Astoria was absolutely beautiful, as is most of Oregon. Just a beautiful drive, and then we got our Goonies on in Astoria and Cannon Beach area, which was really fun.
My surprise was Cannon Beach. I really, really liked that little town. It was cute.
Yeah, I don't think we expected there to be anything there at all other than Haystack Rock.
And yeah, a lot of these towns are like tiny, teeny towns with fishermen, and that's about it. But no, that one was like a cutesy town.
Right, and so we found it a couple like that. And it's hit or miss. Like, all the way up here, I will say this. We took a little detour off of 101 on Highway 105. We did a little loop up through this peninsula just south of here, and I really don't think it's worth it. I mean, there was literally all the little towns that we saw there. We were excited because we thought all these little towns would be these cool little harbor towns, and then a lot of them were just nothing. Or we just didn't actually see the town and drove by them. I don't know. But that little jog around 105, I think that that's not something that we'll ever do again. It's just, I don't think it was worth it. We'll stay on 101. But we're now in Ocean City, Washington, just southwest of Seattle. And we'll be heading up into Seattle for in the next couple of days. But for now, we're just going to sit here, get some work done, try to get caught up on a little bit of stuff. And that means this is where we're going to end this one. So we'd love for you to hang out with us a little bit, get to know us, maybe join us on some of our travels. And that means you have to do what?
Subscribe.
Hit that subscribe button. And it would be really cool if you liked the video as well. And we'll see you again in the next one. Bye now.
Follow us on Instagram also and Facebook.
Yes, Lori.
The Motorhome Experiment.
Lori's handling that stuff. So.
Bye, guys.
Bye now. Ozzy.
Quiet, Raven. Don't you know Ravens, we're trying to shoot something
the
here?
The Ravens are not like an Ozzy. They don't really like when Ozzy comes out.
Ozzy's behind the picnic table, if you can see.
Over there, just hanging out. So, all right, I got to get some work done. Bye now. So that means we're going to end it.
That means this is where we're going to end
yes.
it.
Yes. Okay. And that means this. These? That was weird.